Imagine you are buying a gift. Would you spend more or less for the same product, whether you buy it for yourself or for somebody else? The same product. We will find out today. You enter a store and you want to buy a gift. And you don't want to screw it up. Research found there are two factors that are particular for gift purchases. First, buying a gift implies some signaling value. So you buy a gift to show somebody else how much do you value the relationship. And this valuing of the relationship might imply a higher willingness to pay. On the other hand, if you are unsure about your recipient's preferences, you are also more likely to rely on price-quality inferences, so you take the price as a signal for quality. And both factors together explain why customers who buy the very same product as a gift would pay about 5.8% more for the very same product. What does it mean for you as a retailer? Frame your product as the perfect gift. What does it mean for you as somebody who receives a gift? Don't tell anybody what you want to have, what you like, and what your preferences are. This might increase the willingness to pay. And lastly, what does it mean for you who is about to give a gift? Ask your friend about his or her preferences. Then you are sure and you don't need to rely on price quality signals anymore. I hope I can give you a spark of inspiration on giving gifts and pricing gifts. And if you need and seek more inspiration on pricing and psychological pricing, join me at pricingnuggets.com. See you there.